Hi guys, so today I'm doing a video on how the parent, the adult, and the child of our parent gives us certain messages which are included in our life script, and how our life script forms, and how we can take it apart to realize what dysfunctional beliefs exist that are hampering us. So certain messages that are passed from the, as we talked about, every parent, every person has the parent, adult, and child within them. So the messages that are sent from the adult part of the parent, that are from the adult part to us, which usually consist of how to do things, how to fix a car, how to deal with people, how to manage your finances, whatever it is. So those are the how to do things messages, and they form the program of our script. Other than that, there are two other sort of messages that are relayed from the parents, and also the interactions between the parents themselves and how they interact with each other is also forming part of our script. And additionally, if we suffer trauma in our early formative years, we can get our complete character can change based on that trauma having a severe impact on our perception of ourselves, our perception of life and the world, and everything else in it. So the parent state of the parent gives counter injunctions, and the child state of the parent gives injunctions and permissions. So what this means is that counter injunctions are basically things that you should do and not do. So they're like things like, don't trust strangers, don't leave your things lying around if you don't want, like if you want to keep them safe, don't go out late at night, don't do this or don't do that, whatever it may be. So these are verbal. And they also define how our parents see people and the world, and that influences the sort of script we form in our head based on that. And then there are pre-verbal messages sent from the child state of the parent, and these are felt like their injunctions and permissions. And if we violate them, we feel like an unpleasant body sensation. So that sensation is... So because these messages were pre-verbal when we couldn't speak, they have been programmed into us. So when we violate those directives, those injunctions and permissions, we feel like negative body sensations because they are programmed into our psyche. And when we violate them, we feel we have violated our own boundaries. And then... So what is important here is that all of these are supposed to be positive, including the, especially the adult messages of how to do things, but they can become negative when the adult part of the parent has been contaminated, which means that they have become negative or they are influenced by other parts like the child. And also, like, I just want to say that all of this depends completely on how the child perceives what is happening. So it's not like a very logical thing, it's more like how the child perceives it. So one example would be like, if you're a child and you're sitting in the back seat of your car and your mom is talking on the phone. So how the child, as in like the subject or whatever the offspring is, so whatever they're feeling from the moment depends completely on their perception of it. So for instance, if they're in the back seat of their car and their mom is talking on the phone, then if they are like screaming for attention because they want it, and their mom says, stop screaming, why do you keep screaming, you're so annoying, so the message that the parent is giving in that instance is that I want you to please be quiet right now. But what the child usually interprets is that this is like an outright rejection. My mom does not want me to be here. And they either feel like maybe I shouldn't exist which is a very common thing for a child to feel. Or they feel like that I'm being rejected. So these people, Bob and Mary Golding, they came up with like 12 injunctions from the child state of the parent that we get. And these are don't be, which is don't exist, like which we just talked about. Then there's don't be you. So this could be your gender or also comparing you to other people. Then there's don't be a child. So like if your parents are very much children themselves, or they could be very like disciplined, strict adults. They might be like, don't be a child, you're too old for this. You shouldn't be crying, boys don't cry, stuff like that. So that has a very serious impact, and that forms our script. And usually things like that can result in depression, because when we are compared to other people, or when our real emotions are not validated, often it creates this like negative feeling, or it creates this feeling of not being good enough, which eventually leads to anger and anger and just like feeling really frustrated and depleted, eventually leading to depression. So then there's don't make it. So this is when like I've seen narcissistic parents are jealous of their children. So they say, so they can actually be in a competition, usually with the father, the eldest son. That's what I've seen more. So usually the father is kind of jealous of the son and wants to have either their level of success or for them not to be more successful than them, whichever. And then there's don't grow up, don't be well, don't be important, don't belong. So this is more like, because these are injunctions, they are not expressly said, but they're felt. So for instance, if some parents tell their children that I wish I didn't have you at that young age, or I wish I didn't have you at all. So what kids, and I know people who have done this, they've internalized the message that I shouldn't exist. So they have difficulty coming out of that. They have difficulty dealing with that later on in life. Then there's don't think, don't feel. So I think especially for people who are their parents are emotionally unavailable, or they have difficulty expressing and tolerating their feelings, whether positive or negative, or processing them properly, they sort of have this sort of thing, don't feel. And then people who are very strict, authoritarian, disciplinarian, or people who think that children should be just seen and not heard, they can have this sort of underlying message that the child receives, which is don't think, just sort of follow what I say. And that also ties in with codependency and people pleasing and fawning and later defense mechanisms that people use later to deal with everything that happened before. So don't be too close, which is like this intimacy fear that is created. And that can sort of mean that like if we've suffered enmeshment, or we've suffered like emotional unavailability, then we can feel like intimacy is dangerous, and because we've never had it in a safe way, we can get this message where like we become like anxious, ambivalent, or we become avoidant. So that is like the message within us, don't be too close. So anxious, ambivalent people have this way of being anxious when the person is not there, but when they are, being like, I don't really care if you're here, it doesn't really matter to me. So that is the ambivalence, that sort of indifference, that it doesn't really matter to me whether you are there or not. When it sort of, they've been trying all along to make that person come close, and when they do, it's like they're pushing that person away. So then there is don't belong, and then don't do anything, as in like Your input is not needed. You don't need to do anything. Everything will be done for you. And that has major repercussions as well later, because if you're not used to doing anything, you're not really gonna get anywhere in life, actually. So, yeah. So, we've gone over the 12 injunctions by Bob and Mary Golding. We've gone over the kind of script messages that we receive and how we form our script. We're going to go more into this later. And I hope you guys liked what we did for today. I think it's a lot of content. And so, let me know which ones of these injunctions actually hit home with you. And we're going to work on the program and the counter injunctions at in a later video. So I hope you guys like this, and I don't want to make it too long because then it's going to become like too much information, and I want to process it slowly, and I want whoever is watching it to process it slowly as well and gradually build on it. So I hope you guys liked it, and I will see you guys soon. Bye bye.